Hey everyone, Mike Vogel here for the Monumental Network, joined by Caps captain Alex Ovechkin today for a very special conversation.
Packed in here, looking to get the puck through. Here's Ovechkin, the shot, he scores! 500!
I just wanted you to watch a couple of these and tell me.
To John Carlson, high slot, Kuznetsov turns, fires, got it away, got it to Rask, rebound, he scores!
I want to start with the Boston one, because I mean, everybody always talks about the your highlight reel goals, the ones where you skate through an entire defense and everything, and those are pretty. To me, this was just as impressive, and this was a highlight reel goal for me. Like, you're right in the middle of the slot there. You got about four white sweaters all around you, and Chara is the guy who's nearest to you, and that puck comes out there, and the first thing you do is lift his stick, and he's not a weak guy. Is that instinct? I mean, what are you thinking there? Because you're it's almost one motion where you lift his stick, and then as you're going down, you swipe it into the net.
You just play for it. Watch the situation, and you just play for it. You want to, like, you can see Kuzi take a shot. I missed the tip, and the puck bounced right to Chara's feet. And I have half a second to lift his stick and take a shot. Sometimes you just have to get dirty ones. And I think this was not that pretty, but you can see, like, he lost for a second and saw that and just lift his stick and put it in.
Well, if you don't lift his stick, he probably clears it.
Yeah, 100%, yeah.
Is he still one of the favorite guys for you to compete against?
Oh, yeah. Like, he's so strong, man. It's always hard to play against those guys.
Second, Ovechkin's away. Ovechkin inside on Talinder. Ovechkin scores!
This one was from the day after Christmas, 2008, against Buffalo, and this is
a lucky move, and try to, you can see, like, I make a move and failed, and again, every shot where you score, or you're going to score, or somebody going to save it, and you didn't see where the puck, where you're shooting, because you fell in, and you try to see where his puck is, and how I said, it's sometimes you just need luck, and luck was on my side this time.
Ovechkin moving up, wrist crossing, sidestepping a hit. What a move! Ovechkin's in! His chance!
I make a couple moves, try to don't lose the puck. My backhand not that great, but you know, it goes in against probably one of the best goalies in the league. Playoffs, you always want to play hard as you can, and Jury right now tried to hit me, he misses, and like, everything that happened, like, so quick, and you just wants to do, like, all the different things.
But you're so good at putting pucks through guys' feet, too.
Yeah.
And that seems to me to be an amazing skill, because the puck's moving, both players are moving. You've only got a really narrow window of time to pull something like that right there.
If you put a puck between the legs, you just have to use your body to protect the puck, and as soon as the guy put his head down, you just have to out-muscle him and take a better position.
Are these things you can practice?
It's hard to practice that kind of stuff, obviously. Like I said, I have a full speed right here, cut in the middle, and then try to do the thing. And like I said, sometimes it's working, sometimes it's not. I get luck to make this play and get a big goal.
And he goes for Hamrelick as both teams change. Hamrelick can't get there. What a move by Ovechkin around Hamrelick. In comes Ovechkin. In front scores. What a goal by Alexander Ovechkin.
After change, fresh legs. So I think Hamrelick, Raman, was kind of tired maybe.
The indirect pass to yourself off the boards.
It's just a creative. Like sometimes you have to make some creative moves. Just that muscle, you can see, like, as soon as you have a space to put puck in front of you and put out muscle guy, I think it's Chura, you just use your body and protect the puck.
Comes out of there with Ovechkin. Alex Ovechkin full throttle, fires and scores!
The one with Hue, or through the defenseman's legs and over the goaltender's shoulder. I think this was the night you had four and maybe broke your nose too.
Just to use a defenseman as a screen. Obviously, it was a pretty good shot. It goes high, and here I don't have a chance to stop it.
I don't see how, with everyone moving and the puck moving, how you're able to get that much elevation on the shot.
You have range of motion, you know, like you just put it back and you know, like the guy, you can see like he missed the puck. As soon as he missed the puck, like I know, like I have a second to take a shot between his legs because the goalie didn't see the puck at all.
Steps in toward the dot, feeds Green in the slot, sets up Ovechkin, he scores!
You said you don't score many on the backhand. Would you say that more of your goals have come on wrist shots or on one-timers?
Probably one-timers. But again, you can see how the guys who give me the pass, if pass is good, the shot is good.
When I first saw you, when you were a teenager, you seemed to prefer the slot. Did it take some adjusting for you to move to the left dot and score so many of your goals from over there?
It's just like a situation when you can see right now, like pass is perfect, like right between my legs. It's almost all the time goes in. Every time, like pass have to be strong, fast enough, and right between my legs. You can see right now, like the pass goes forward, so the shot was not that good, but it goes in because of deflection on the stick. Like if he's shooting from this side, if puck goes this side, better if puck goes a little bit in the middle or in your left side, left leg.
When you're shooting from that dot and you're taking those one-timers, are you just want it on net, or are you thinking at all short side, far side?
Sometimes you just see where the goalie have to stay, because you can see right now he moves, and like goalie don't know always where the puck goes, because I didn't even know where the puck goes too. It's hard for them. It's not hard for me.
Thanks to Alex Ovechkin for spending some time with us going over his life and his career here in Washington. And hopefully there's a lot more of what we saw here today to come in the years ahead.